Yes. So, most of you have heard about it. It's called Pascal, and it's from Edwards. And before talking about differences, I think the similarities you can easily judge from these photographs. And they're both doing the same thing, edge-to-edge approximation in the leaflets, but with slight differences on how they do it. And also, as you can see, although the general concept is the same, you can see some differences in the design. And first of all, let's see what happens in the fields of stress catheter treatments and where is mitral valve in comparison to the aortic valve. So you see here the numbers of prevalence of valvular disease in the United States. And after so many years of expansion of stress catheter treatments, as you can see, approximately 15% of aortic stenosis is treated. So this is a big advance. And on the other hand, you have, contrary, the mitral valve, where you have the most patients, the population with significant disease is the largest, and there the penetration of transcatheter treatments is very, very little. It's 1.5%. So there is a big difference between the aortic valve field and the mitral valve field, and some of it may be related to the difficulties, to the differences between the two valves, how straightforward is to do a TAVI, and about the causes of mitral regurgitation and the different diseases, the different substrates. But some of it may also relate to the devices that are out in the market. So here are the TAVR volumes over the years, and you can see this constant increase, the rise of the numbers from the introduction in the market in 2007. And these are the numbers per year over the world now. So for 2019, it's expected to have 150,000 TAVI procedures all over the world. But already back in 2012, as you can see, we had 32,000 TAVR procedures all over the world. And these numbers are coming very, very acute contrast with and the mitral clip experience. So although they were both introduced and got CE mark in the same year, we have shown you that the TAVR numbers, and here are the mitral clip numbers. So it was very, very slow up to 2013, and then gradually it started going up, but still the total numbers of patients treated with mitral clip is 70,000 patients. So these are the patients treated with TAVR just before 2012. So it's lagging back a lot. And why is that? One reason might be related to the data, the supportive data, the evidence-based produced by clinical trials, and especially from randomized clinical trials. And we've all witnessed the field of TAVR and how beautiful trials have been generated there all over the years. And many of them, as you can see here, the PATENT trials, the SHOT-TAVI, the CoreValve pivotal trials, and lately the PATENT-3 and the low risk. So about 9,000 patients have been enrolled in these randomized clinical trials, and the CE mark was granted in 2007. So in contrast, this is the randomized clinical trials from the mitral valve, from the mitral clip. So it was introduced about the same year, CE mark 2008, and there was one clinical randomized trial, the EVEREST, with a very small number of patients, and it required about 15, 14 years to see the next randomized clinical trials, COAPT and MITRA France, that we discussed earlier. But still, the total number of patients enrolled in RCTs with mitral clip is very low compared to that of TAVR. So let's see the details and the dimensions of the two systems. So here is the mitral clip. It comes in two sizes now, the NTR and the XTR. And you can see that the total length of the small, let's call it like that, small mitra clip is 15 millimeters, and of the large, when it's closed, is 18 millimeters. The other very relevant thing is the grasping area, where the leaflets are going. In the small is 6 millimeters, in the large is 9 millimeters, and finally the total opening area is 20 millimeters here, 22 millimeters here. So these are the numbers that you should remember. And finally, the width is 5 millimeters for both the small and the large one. And here's the Pascal, and you can see the differences. First of all, let's start from the most evident. The width is double the width of both mitra clip systems. It's 10 millimeters. The length of the device is 18 millimeters. The opening and the clasping area is 9 millimeters. But then there is also another difference here, because the gap between the clasps is bigger than the gap we have in the mitra clip. So the total spanning area is larger than 9, and 9 that adds to 18 is actually 24. And then you can see the, all the other specifications that are less important than the numbers. So what Pascal does is grasping and approximating the leaflets, but also putting a spacer, having this incorporated part of the design between them. So the leaflets, when they close, they don't come in touch to each other, but we have the spacer in between. And here is the naming, because the terminology is slightly different to mitra clip. So we have the spacer, the central part, and we have the paddles instead of the arms of the mitra clip, and then we have the clasps that are the inside instead of the grippers. And the delivery system is pretty similar to the mitra clip. So we have the guide catheter, the steerable catheter, and the implant catheter. And here you can see the various stages and alignments of the device, when it's closed, when it's open with the clasps down, open with one clasp up, one down, and when it's completely elongated. And we'll discuss about this positions later on. So here you see how the procedure is very similar to the mitra clip in the transeptal puncture, and then it's very different how you manipulate the device to get it down to the mitral valve. And then, as you can see, this device has the feature of independent leaflet grasping that is very unique. So if you have difficulties to get the leaflets together, you can get one and then move to the other one and get it independently, which is something that sometimes is used and it makes the difference. So like this case, you see a patient with anterior leaflet prolapse. It was difficult to grasp them together. From Neil Pham from Toronto, and as you can see, first the anterior leaflet was grasped, and then the system was moved posteriorly, and the posterior leaflet was grasped independently with this final result. So the wider system, the 10 millimeters, it's double the mitra clip width. It maximizes the leaflet coaptation. So you encapsulate a larger length of the leaflets. And then, as I said earlier, we have this central spacer that fills in the gap between the leaflets. Also, this spacer minimizes or reduces the stresses exerted on the leaflets, because they don't have to come one or to contact with each other. So they preserve some of their original anatomic position. And also, the other difference is that this device, it doesn't close like a vice grip, but it closes by spring action of the paddles. So there is some radial force that can actually move the paddles out. So with the movement of the heart especially at the top of the device, you can actually see it moving, opening slightly and closing with every heartbeat. And here you can see how the complete elongation of the device is very helpful when you are below the leaflets and you want to retract for whatever reason. So you don't have, like MitraClip, you have wings. You go to invert position, you have those wings behind, and you cross like that. With this system, everything becomes straight, like a road, and then you pull it back. So this makes the retraction much easier and safer. This is the animation of the procedure with this system. And as you can see, the other big difference between the two devices is the orientation of the spikes on the clasps. The spikes on the Pascal clasps are horizontal. And as you noticed earlier, the spikes on the grippers of the MitraClip are vertical. So they're across the shaft. And this difference may be important. It's one of the things we have to look for in the future. So here you see a sagittal section of the leaflets with the MitraClip device and with the Pascal device. So you see how close, with the vice grip closer of the MitraClip, the leaflets go, and you see some relaxation and some preservation of their original anatomical position with a Pascal device. And then you see the width of the device and the width of the bridge. Because it's wider, the Pascal, you get a wider bridge. And then what I told you earlier about the grasping areas, for the MitraClip, the small is 6 millimeters. So this is the area that the leaflet has to go, and 9 millimeters for the large clip. And for the Pascal is 9 millimeters, but the spanning is larger, so it adds to 25 in total. So the delivery system here again, the guide catheter is 22 friends, is hydrophilic, plastic, very hydrophilic, and it's similar, but not exactly the same to the guide catheter of the MitraClip, which is the same size, it's hydrophilic, but it has a coil wire incorporated that makes it really stiff, very stiff. And what is the data we have so far? We have the compassionate use experience that we participated in 29 patients. I go through this very quickly. It was as expected, and I want to concentrate in the CLASP study that was first presented in the German cardiology meeting, I think 1 week ago. So this is the second presentation. So this was a single arm study that its submission led to a granting of the CE mark to this device. So very standard inclusion and exclusion criteria included both FMR and DMR, and safety and performance endpoints, the centers that participated, Cybelcar is here. Also participated in the study, and we had in total 62 patients in this study. These are the demographics, 76-year-old etiology, as you can see, mostly functional, but the degenerative is also up and mixed. MR severity 3 or above in all patients, successful implantation in all but 2 patients. And the mean number of devices per patient was 1.5 pascals, the procedure duration about 2 hours. And these are the maze. There was only 1 cardiovascular mortality, and all the rest were really low, close to zero. 6% the total maze. And the results, the MRR reduction at 30 days, they're really impressive. 98% 0 to 2 grades, and 86% 0 or 1. One of the best results we have seen with approximation, leaflet approximation, improvement in symptoms, 6-minute walk test, quality of life. And the conclusion is that this device, despite that this is the original application, the original usage, the rolling out, the first for most of the operators were the first cases, it managed to produce the same result with mitral clip approximation. That is, the experience there is for years and for thousands of patients. So this led to the CE mark very recently. And in this table, it's just my perception of the difference between the two. So I talked about them earlier. So the clasping-grasping mechanism is different. Spring versus vice grip. The leaflet tip geometry is partially preserved, but altered with mitral clip. The sizing, the dimensions, the independent grasping, the layout on retraction, which is different. And the ease of the guide insertion is very hydrophilic, very easy, the Pascal compared to the mitral clip. Complexity of the delivery system, it's easier. And last I left the two things that there may be mitral clip better behaving in those, for those two, like the entry in between dense cordae in the commissural areas, because it's a thinner device compared to mitral clip, and also for the same reason, and the acoustic shadows we have on transesophageal echo may be less. And I'll finish by showing to you just two cases. This is an ischemic FMR patient, but just looking at this, you would expect that to be a multi-clip case because we have a very wide vena contractor, as you can see. And the error was 0.5, I believe. This is the 3D color, the baseline, the measurements, vena contracta, and the MVQ analysis. This is a transeptal puncture. You can see the wire initially, and here is the device. And I think here you will see how it changes from the elongated position to the default position when we pull it back. I think it's the next one, here. So you see how it's elongated and how you retract it back and it takes the default position. And then all the rest are, of the procedure are very similar to the mitral procedure, so you're looking to get perpendicularity to the cooptation light. This is how the device appears on fluoroscopy, and when you get perpendicularity, then you cross the leaflets and you clasp the two leaflets and you close the device. And if you're happy, like in this case, with one device, we got this bridge and we had this huge reduction by just one device. Here is released. The final result, mean gradient 3, and the reversal of the pulmonary flow disappeared. And here you see what was the final result with just one device. I think this is remarkable given the extension of the regurgitation, and I would like to hear the rest of the users here if they would expect to get the same result with just one clip. And just one case with DMR, as you see the P2 prolapse here, it's quite wide, and typical P2 prolapse, you see the MVQ scan and the eccentric jet and going to anteriorly, and here is again the device perpendicularity. Here you see it open and between below the leaflets, and here is the closure of the device and creating the bridge release, and here is the final result with just one device and a very wide bridge there, and then we finish with one, and we put a second lateral to that, sorry, this is another case. So this is the result with one, and then we put a second, this is an FMR case, and so this is a two device case with a very good final result. And by showing to you this, three cases, finally, I'd like to thank you for your attention.
Impressive results indeed, Dr. Sparrias. Let me grab the opportunity and make you two very short questions, actually. The first would be, Are there any pre-specified features, imaging features, that would make you prefer one device to another? And the second is, what is our experience with the Pascal repair system? Thank you.
The experience, I'll start with the second question. The experience with Pascal is very limited compared to the experience of the MitraClip. So it's very early to draw conclusions, you know, about comparisons. But generally speaking, it's a user-friendly device. And if you're experienced with MitraClip, it is quite easy to use. And my perception of the differences are out in that table that I showed you earlier. So there are many things that it plays differently to MitraClip. We don't know to what extent this will materialize in clinical, better clinical outcomes. But certainly the theory and the device design is different, and I think it's very likely it will produce better results for a number of patients with special anatomies, and especially I think it will facilitate to finish many procedures with just one device, which will make the procedure shorter and safer, and still getting the same result.
Thank you very much, Dr. Spargas. First of all, I would like to thank